today is Saturday. We're heading off now to Ponderosa for breakfast, and then straight on to Animal Kingdom.
From the day we arrived on the planet, and when we step into the sleigh, there's more to see than can ever be seen, more to do than can ever be done. There's far too much to take in here, more to find than can ever be found. But the sun rolling high in the sapphire sky, it's great and small on the endless round. It's the sun.
Shy animals that spend most of their day in the bushes. They will live here for two breeding cycles, so that is 2 years and 4 months. The baby's right there. If you look backwards, he's about 10 months old. He's standing about 9 feet tall these days.
bare necessities. Forget about your worries and your trash. I mean the bare necessities.
The patriarchs are actually the one closest to the baobab tree back here. And sometimes they would meet at this wall here where the ditches is. It was for their horns. Wherever I roam. Rhino horn sells on the black market for about $35,000 a pound, making it more valuable than both gold and platinum.
Put a buzzing in the tree to make some honey just for me. When you look under the rocks,
ostrich, zebra,
at the fancy ants, then maybe
a desert antelope normally found in the Sahara. If it had to, the addicts could go about 7 years without drinking one sip of water.
The bare necessities of life will come to you. They'll come to you. Look for the bare necessities, the simple bare necessities. Forget about your worries and your strife. I mean the bare necessities. That's why a bear can rest at ease with just the bare necessities of life. Now when you pick a pawpaw or a prickly pear, and you prick a raw paw, well next time, beware. Don't pick the prickly pear by the paw. When you pick a pear, try to use the claw. But you don't need to use the claw when you pick a pear of the big pawpaw. Have I given you a clue? The bare necessities of life will come to you. They'll come to you.
Fast pass at 2:30, so we've got a couple of hours to waste. Well, not waste, but explore the area.
So just try and relax. Fall apart in my backyard. Because let me tell you something, little Richards. If you act like that bee, you're working too hard. And don't spend your time looking around for something you want that can't be found. When you find out you can live without it and go along not thinking about it, I'll tell you something true. The bare necessities of life will come to you. Look for the bare necessities, the simple bare necessities. Forget about your worries and your strife. I mean the bare necessities. That's why a bear can rest at ease with just the bare necessities. Yeah, with just the bare necessities.
Here we go. Your screen. Here it is. It's probably some of the problems that humans have caused. Things like, whoa, what? Okay, Pogo, calm down. Sorry about that. Some of the problems humans caused, things like pollution, habitat loss. What is this? Pogo, are you okay? You are. Okay, good. Habitat loss. That's enough. Miss, can you please pay attention? Hold on. You can? Are you sure? Okay, good. Habitat loss, misuse of chemicals, and pollution. These are all really big problems. Pogo, that is enough. Really big problems. Problems that are getting a lot more attention, and problems that are completely out of control, like this bird. I'm so sorry. Pogo, hey, look, will you? Wait, look. Will you listen to me? I think we're getting somewhere. Now, I do have to let you all in on a little secret. This parrot is incredibly smart, but he doesn't understand what I'm saying. He's watching or listening for cues. That do-do-do-do, it's just the right hand up and down. Yeah, I like that. If I want him to shake his head yes, I just cross my hands. A flip on the perch is a point down. Point down, there you go. This one I didn't do, but he'll copy my head movement. I love this one. Yeah, so cute. And then if I throw the right arm out like this, that's when we get back.
What is that?
I have no idea what that is. Oh, Foster, there's a dollar bill out there. Do you want to show everybody what you do with all that money? You see him out there? Yes, what do you do? Yeah, you gotta go on out there. He's got the dollar. What do you do with all the money, Foster? What? You got it. And where does it go? Yeah! Thank you. That was awesome. Who wants to try it with a 20 over here? I'm teasing. Sir, go ahead, stand up again with your arm out and your palm up. He'll put it right in that hand. You just wrap your fingers around it so it doesn't blow away. Foster is going to do all the work. There you go, Foster. And you got it. How about for a Sariyama. This right here is what they'll do with, with any rodent or reptile they find in the wild. See, they eat rodents and reptiles. So when they find them, they search for a hard surface like a rock, and then they pulverize their prey. And flying out to Rebecca in the very back. Now, Heratops, like Orion, they're found in the desert southwest part of the United States. And they're unique. Get ready, guys. Here he comes.
Wow.
Frazier. And Hope is a living symbol of one of the greatest conservation success stories of our time. See, it wasn't long ago that bald eagles were in such great danger of extinction.
I'm a female back there.
In the bird world, females are always born.
They're very friendly.
Robin Hood and Little John walking through the forest, laughing back and forth at what the other has to say. Reminiscing this and that and having such a good time. Oodle-lolly, golly, what a day. Never ever thinking there was danger in the water they were drinking, they just guzzled it down. Ever dreaming that a scheming sheriff and his posse was watching them and gathering around? Robin Hood and Little John running through the forest, jumping fences, dodging trees, and trying to get away. Contemplating nothing but escaping, finally making it. Oodle-lolly, oodle-lolly, golly, what a day. Oodle-lolly, oodle-lolly, golly, what a day.
Then we're going to grab an early night so we can get up early tomorrow for Discovery Cove.